Today I'm gonna pot up this large banana tree into a larger pot, and the only way we can get it out is by cutting the pot. So we cut it on each side, and now we will finally be able to get that root ball out of there. We were unable to get it out of there because it's bulging through the container here, and it was so stuck in there that the only way to get it out was to cut this container. I am super upset because I love those containers, but hey, sometimes you gotta sacrifice for the good. I'm going to go ahead and carry the banana tree over here. It isn't that heavy since it was in a smaller pot and the root isn't too large. And we're gonna go ahead and place it into this larger pot. This is a 3-foot-high by 3-foot round pot. And I already have just a little bit of soil in there already. And then we'll add more once we get the root ball in here. As you can see, I just have a couple pots in there holding it, so that way it stays straight if we get a little bit of a wind rush here, and I'll remove it as soon as we get more soil in there to hold it on its own. Once I placed it in there, I then went ahead and packed the soil in around the side so it holds it up nicer, and that way the dirt doesn't settle, and then that way the banana tree doesn't move around. And we are going to go ahead and plant a few other things in there, so we have some beautiful color along the bottom with foliages and some trailing over the side as well. We went ahead and planted it up, and now I'll go ahead and share with you what varieties that I planted in here. In the back, I added one of my larger coleus plants called Twist and Twirl. So I placed that in the back, and that's the only large plant that I've placed in there. Some of the growth on it is pretty tall, so I'm actually going to go ahead and pinch it. All pinching does is stops the plant from growing up, and it forces all of the growth along all of the stems of the plant to bush out. All we do is come in here on the top of the plant right here, and we remove that top part. I'm going to show you a quick example. This coleus here was in one of those same size pots, and it was the same size as the other one, and just 1 month ago we planted it in this 12-inch terracotta pot. Well, the color terracotta. It's not a terracotta pot, it's plastic. But we went ahead and pinched it, and look at how huge it has already bushed out. And it's already ready for another set of pinching on it, like right here. As soon as you can start seeing through the foliage, as you can tell, I'm starting to see through the foliage on the top. That's when I want to pinch, so keep staying super full like it is on the bottom where you don't see through it at all. So right here, this one's coming up, you can see right through it. So you could pinch it right here, or you could really just come into the center of that plant and just take that little itty bitty center. But I'm gonna go ahead and take it right here, so that way it gets rid of all of that emptiness. And that way it'll start bushing out. Right there, as you can see, that's the new growth. That's what's gonna grow up next, along with everything else along that stem. See all these little growths here? Those all start growing out as soon as you get rid of that piece. Moving on, over here now, this dark foliage is Alter and Thera. I love Alter and Thera. At least I love the Purple Night. The Purple Night is the very large, vigorous variety. It is so beautiful. It'll go up, it'll go down, and it'll fill in any empty space in a container. And by fall time, it almost gives off kind of a spooky feel. I don't know what it is about it, but that's why I love it, because it looks great in the summertime, but it also looks amazing through the fall. Then next to that, I have the Campfire Coleus right here, this beautiful orange one. In front here, we've got the Iboza vine. You may know it as the candlestick vine. What's really cool about it is that it can take sun or shade. And it just really trails beautifully, and it'll fill in gorgeous and pop through in different little sections wherever it's empty, just like the altar anthera. And I love the variegation on the leaves. It has such a beautiful scent. Next to that, we have one of my absolute favorite coleus called French Quarters. This one gets huge. I put it in my window boxes 2 years ago. I just love it. It's one of those though that does have to be controlled because it gets overly large, so we will have to pinch it. Over here we have a skyscraper salvia. I love adding little salvias intermixed into everything because they are just hummingbird attractors. And then right behind the Iboza vine is the Rockin' Blue Suede Shoes Salvia by Proven Winners. And then next we've got the Blind Potato Vine. This one is by Proven Winners and it's called Margarita. So this is the more aggressive variety, the long trailer that you see us use in a lot of our containers. And then over here, once again, we have the Campfire Coleus. And the Campfire Coleus can also take sun or shade. And then in the back here, we have another altar anthera. So this back area here and on the side mimics the other side and back. So that way as it grows in, you'll have a very symmetrical look with color and texture. And then in the front, that's where you kind of throw in just that little extra touch of like, whoa, there's a party going on in that pot. And that's what we like to create. Now keep your fingers crossed for us because we have never had to bump up a banana tree before. We have never wintered one before. We wintered this one. It was a small plant last season, only about a foot. Brought it into the greenhouse all winter and here it is today. And we have another one. It's not as large, but we're just really hoping it lasts for us. We look forward to sharing the updates and the progress of this container. We hope you guys love this video and this little combination. Well, not little, big combination. So if you don't already subscribe, feel free to subscribe and don't forget to click on that bell. We don't want you to miss any future videos. All right, thank you so much, you guys. Have a great day.